फ्रेंड्स, वो स्टार्टेड आर लेसन नंबर 6 यस्टरडे, द वाइट माउस सर्कस। इन दैट स्टोरी वी केम टू नो दैट दिस स्टोरी इज़ अबाउट अ बॉय हु जस्ट विजिटेड अ प्लेस इन इंग्लैंड विद हिज ग्रैंडमदर ड्यूरिंग हिज वकेशन। इट वॉज अ वेरी वंडरफुल होटल वेयर दे स्टेड, बट द बॉय वॉज फीलिंग बोरिंग देयर एज there was no activity for him, but as a consolation his grandmother gave him a gift of white mice. So he was happy on that gift. He wanted to train them, but there was an unhappy scene created on the very first day of their arrival at the hotel when the manager did not allow the boy to let his mice out of the cage. So he had to follow these instructions, but he wanted to train them also. So he was now in search a safer place where he could let them out of the cage and train them. So he was in his on his mission on finding out some safer place, and we were there on the third page of the lesson when he was just searching for an empty place where he could train his white mouse. And here he is telling that there is no way you can train mice inside a cage, yet I dared not let them out because the chambermaid was spying on me all the time. She had a key to my door and she kept bursting in all hours trying to catch me with the mice out of the cage. So that chambermaid, who was afraid of that white mice, she just kept an eye on that boy. If he let them out of the cage, she just complained about him to the manager of the hotel. So he decided to seek a safer place where I could carry on with the training. There must surely be an empty room in this enormous hotel. I put one mouse into each trouser pocket and wandered downstairs in search of a secret spot. Now he is on his mission to find out a secret place where he could train his mouse. And the ground floor of the hotel was a maze of the public rooms. It means that the ground floor is, there are many rooms, all of them named in gold letters on the doors. I wandered through the lounge, the card room, the reading room and the drawing room. None of them was empty. So the boy moved here and there to find out some place where he could carry on his mission, but all the rooms were full of people. I went down a long white corridor, and at the end of it came to the ballroom. So at the end of the corridor there was a ballroom. There were double doors leading into it, and in front of the door there was a large notice board on a stand. The notice on the board said, there was a notice board on the door of that room, and what is written on the notice board, we can see here. This room is reserved for the annual meeting, the Royal Society for the Prevention of the Cruelty to Children. So that room was empty actually. The double doors into the room were open. I peeped in. It was a colossal room. There were rows and rows of the chairs, and all facing a platform. The chairs were painted gold and they had little red cushions on the seats, but there was not a soul in the sight. So the room was very beautifully decorated, and there were many chairs, red and golden, but there was no person in that room. So he found that place, safer place for him to carry on his business. I sidled into the room. The meeting of the Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to the Children must have taken place earlier in the day. So the boy thought that meeting would rather have been done in the morning, and now they had all gone home. Even if they had not, even if they did suddenly come pouring in, they would be wonderful, kind people who would look with the favor upon a young mouse trainer going about his business. So he was not afraid of the people. If they would come there, they would be kind to him. Because he was a child, and that meeting was also relating to stop the cruelty against the child. So they would be very kind people. If they saw him there, they would not say him anything. So he was not afraid. He find himself safe there. At the back of the room, there was a large folding screen with Chinese dragons painted on it. I decided to go behind that screen and do my training there. I was not a bit frightened of the prevention of cruelty to the children people, but there was always a chance that the manager, Mr. Stringer, might pop his head round the door. So he just decided to go behind that screen. This was a safer place for him. He was not afraid of the people of the meeting, but he just thought that if the manager came there, there would be another problem for him. So he just decided to sit behind that screen and do his business. I tiptoed to the back of the room and settled myself on the carpet behind the big screen. What a splendid place this was, ideal for mouse training. I took William and Mary out of my trouser pockets. They sat beside me on the carpet, quiet and well behaved. These were two mice whose name he kept William and Mary, and he put them in his pockets. So there on the safer place, he just took them out from their pockets and he started his business of training them. He was happy to find a good place for his work. The trick I was going to teach them today was tightrope walking. It is not all that difficult to train an intelligent mouse to be an expert tightrope walker, provided you know exactly how to go about it. First, you must have a piece of string. I had that. So that boy, he wanted to train the mice to walk on a tightrope. And he had a rope, and there he started to train the mice to walk on the tight rope. Then you must have some good cake. A fine carrot cake is the favorite food of the white mice. I had brought with me a rock cake, which I had pocketed the day before. You stretch the string tight between your two hands, but you start by keeping it very short. So he just made the preparation for the training of the mice. There was a string. He just wanted to keep that string in his two hands, make it tight, and one hand is one side of the string, and the other side there would be something to eat for the mice, a piece of cake. So the mice would walk on that piece of the rope. Only about 3 inches, and that rope was only for 3 inch long, very short distance. First he put the mouse on your right hand and a little piece of the cake on your left hand. The mouse is therefore only 3 inches away from the cake, so the mouse can smell the cake. He can see it and he can smell it. His whiskers twitch with excitement. So when the mouse just see the cake, he smell the cake, he just was full of excitement. He can almost reach the cake by leaning forward, but not quite. He only has to take 2 steps along the string to reach this tasty morsel. So there was not a long distance between the cake and the mouse, and the mouse has to walk on the string to reach that piece of cake. So the mouse was ready to walk on that string. He ventures forward, one paw on the string, then the other. If the mouse has a good sense of the balance, and most of them have, he will get across easily. I started with William. He walked the string without a moment's hesitation. I let him have a quick nibble of the cake just to whet his appetite. So he just started his trick. He just started it with the mouse. His name was William. And he just put him on his one hand, and on the other side there was a piece of cake, and the mouse just wanted to eat that piece of cake. So just he was ready to walk on the piece of string and reach on the other side of the rope, and he just gave him the piece of cake to just make him to sharpen his appetite. Then I put him back on my right hand. Again he just repeated his trick. This time I lengthened the string. I made it about 6 inches long with superb balance. William walked step by step along the string until he reached the cake. He was rewarded with another nibble. So he just repeated the trick. He just lengthened the length of the cake, a length of the rope, so the mouse can walk more briskly on the walk to get the piece of cake. And the mouse just completed this time also. And again, as a reward, he get a piece of cake. Then I put him back on my right hand. This time I lengthened the string. I made it about 6 inches. Yes, next time when he repeated the trick, first the length of the rope was 3 inches. Now he lengthened the rope for 6 inches. So the mouse again walked on that string more expertly and he reached on the other side of the rope. Quite soon William was walking a 24-inch tight rope for rather tight string from one hand to the other to reach the cake. So now the mouse was trained to walk on the tight rope. First it was 3 inches, then 6 inches, and gradually he just extended the length of the rope, and now it was of 24 inches. And now the mouse can walk on that tight rope even 24 inches, and he could reach on the other side of the rope. He was enjoying himself tremendously. He was enjoying very much. I was careful to hold the string near the carpet so that if he did lose balance, he wouldn't have far to fall. But he never fell. William was obviously a natural acrobat, a great tightrope walking mouse. So the boy was very much happy that the mouse was trained now to walk on the string. He felt that this mouse was a natural acrobat. He could walk very briskly on the rope, tight rope. Now it was Mary's turn. He just tried the same trick on the other mouse. I put William on the carpet beside me and rewarded him with some extra crumbs and a carrot. Then I started going through the same routine all over again with Mary. So he just left now. William on one side and gave him some pieces of cake, and he started his training with Mary. My blinding ambition, you see, my dream of dreams was to become one day the owner of a white mouse circus. The boy, he had a dream now to become an owner of a circus where he would show his acts with white mouse. I would have a small stage with red curtains in front of it, and when the curtains were drawn apart, the audience would see my world famous performing mice walking on trampoline, on tightropes, swinging from trapeze, turning somersaults in air, bouncing on trampoline, and all the rest of it. So the boy was dreaming of becoming an owner of a circus, white mouse circus, where his white mice will perform different type of the actions, acrobatic actions. They are just walking on the trapeze and somersaults in the air and bouncing on the trampolines, different acrobatic actions, and he was thinking about it and all the rest of it. I would have white mice riding on white rats, and the rats would gallop furiously round and round the stage. He was just thinking about his circus when there were many white mice who were running across the stage, and they were doing different acts, and there were many people who were enjoying their acts. I was beginning to picture myself traveling first class all over the globe with my famous white mouse circus and performing before all the crowned head of Europe. So the boy was dreaming here now that he would have a white mouse circus, and he would traveling throughout the world with his famous circus, and all the important people of Europe are enjoying his circus. So what will happen next in the story? For that we have to go through the full story.